We're going to discuss a few different types of word problems that often occur during discussions of rational expressions. As usual with word problems, the hardest part of these is not the solving part, it's setting up the equation that you need to solve. So in this video, we're going to be setting up equations, but we won't be solving them. We'll leave that to you. This is an example where we have two people who are working together to try and complete a job. We're told that Betty can mow a lawn in 30 minutes by herself, and Melissa can mow the same lawn in 90 minutes by herself. And the natural question to ask is, well, what if they're working together? How long will it take them if they're both trying to mow that lawn? The first thing we should do here is set up a variable to represent our answer. Since we care about the time to mow the lawn, let's define t to be the lawn mow time. Now let's turn our attention to Betty and Melissa. For Betty, we are told that it takes her 30 minutes to do the entire lawn. The key here is to convert that total work time into a work rate. If she does the whole thing in 30 minutes, then she does 1/30th of it per minute. Similarly with Melissa, if it takes her 90 minutes to do the whole thing, then she does 1/90th of it per minute. Looking back at Betty, if she does 1/30th of the lawn every minute, then after 2 minutes, she finishes 2/30ths of it. After 3 minutes, she finishes 3/30ths of it. More generally, if T is the amount of time that Betty has been working, then T over 30 represents how much of the lawn that Betty has mowed in that time. Same thing with Melissa. If she does 1/90th of it every minute, then after t minutes, she has finished t over 90 of the lawn. Now, since Betty and Melissa are working together, the total amount of work that they have done is the amount of work that Betty has done plus the amount of work that Melissa has done. So our expression for the total work they've completed is Betty's work plus Melissa's work, and we want that to be equal to one whole lawn. If we solve this equation, it will tell us how long it's going to take them to complete that task. In this problem, we're told that a woman can do two things in the same amount of time. Namely, she can bike 75 miles in the same amount of time that it takes her to walk 21 miles. And then we also know that she can ride her bike 9 miles per hour faster than she can walk. The question is, how fast can she walk? Notice that in this problem we're given information about distance, rate, and time, and so it would make sense that we're going to use the distance formula, distance equals rate times time. Although in this case, we are given a lot of information about distances, and a fair amount of information about rates, and not so much information about time. This suggests that in our d equals rt, we want to get the stuff that we know, the d and the r, on the same side of the equation. So if we rewrite this with t by itself, time is equal to distance over rate. The other thing we should do off the bat is make up a variable to represent our answer. If we want to know how fast she can walk, then let's say x could be her walk speed. From this, we can also come up with an expression for her biking speed, because we know that she bikes 9 miles per hour faster than she walks. And so if x is her regular walking speed, then x plus 9 is going to be her bike speed. We weren't told very much about time in this situation, but what we do know is that it takes this woman the same time to do two tasks. In other words, the time for her to walk is equal to the time for her to bike. We have our d over r expression, which is the same as time, and so we can use that to incorporate the walking speed and the biking speed into the equation that we just created. For the walk, her distance was 21 miles, that's what we were told, and her rate is x, that's what we defined her walking speed to be. That's going to be equal to, her distance for the bike was 75 miles, and her bike speed was the x plus 9 miles per hour faster than she can walk. Well, now we have an equation involving x. If we solve it, we will figure out what her walking speed is. In this problem, we are given some information about a round trip that was done at two different speeds, one speed on the first leg of the trip, and then another speed on the second leg of the trip. As you might expect, we're going to be using our distance equals rate times time formula, but once again, it's going to make a little more sense in this case to view it as time equals distance over rate. Now, the thing we're asked to find is the speed driven while returning. Well, why don't we call the return trip the second leg of the trip? And so we can define our variable x to be the second leg speed. We can also use this to come up with an expression for the first leg speed, because we know that the second leg was supposed to be 40 miles per hour faster than the first leg. And so if x is the second leg speed, then x minus 40 is the first leg speed. And now it's time to talk about time. We're given a comparison between the times of the two trips. We're told that we saved 4 hours on the return. So the second leg was supposed to be 4 hours faster than the first leg. Well, we can make an equation out of that. The time for the second leg should be the time for the first leg minus 4 hours, because we saved 4 hours. And now we have all the components to put together our final equation. We can use the distance over rate formula here to plug in an expression for the second leg time and for the first leg time, and that will give us an equation we can solve. So for the second leg, our distance was half of the total round trip, so 210 miles. And our rate was x, that's what we defined it to be. On the other side, for the first leg of the trip, well, once again, the distance was 210 miles. That was the first half of the trip. And our rate was x minus 40. Minus 4 doesn't change. So here is our equation. If we solve it, it will tell us what our speed was on the second leg of the trip.